Hi everybody. Today I'm going to present something a little bit different. I hope you enjoy it. I'll explain it right after this word from my AI sponsor.
Hello, and welcome to the Matrix Game of Life. It is the generosity of viewers like you that makes this channel possible. If you find the information provided as being beneficial, please send a thank you gift. It will be much appreciated. A PayPal link can be found in the description section of all videos. May your Matrix experience be one of health and of prosperity.
I welcome all of you. And today, I'm going to present to you a 13th century Sufi sutra. A sutra is like a short writing. I didn't do the whole thing. It's not that long as it is. I took certain excerpts out of it that all fell together and they're the body of what was written. Now, for those of you who don't know, the Sufis are, some would call them a mystical type of, it's not really a religion, it's more of a philosophical belief system. And supposedly, this writing was authored by the Prophet Muhammad. Now, most of us know that Muhammad founded the Islam religion, but evidently he did have some dealings with the Sufi mystics, and his writing reflects that big time. I put it up in 7 frames, and you can do a little bit of reading, because that's how they're presented. Each frame has its own set of stanzas, verses. And I do narrate it. And it turned out okay. It was kind of harder to produce than I thought it would be. But I'm learning. I'm learning how to be a YouTube video producer. Woo! I highly suggest that as you watch the video, that you keep your mouse pointer over the pause button. Because what is written and what I'm presenting is some really deep stuff. You have to pay attention. You gotta watch the video more than once. I'd suggest you write down, if you care to, what's being said. It's not that long. It really isn't. It's very, very on the mark and informative, if I do say so myself. So I hope you enjoy it. It's something different. This will be a shorter video than I usually do. And I'm sure you're all glad to hear that. It's a shorter video, but it took me 3 times longer to make. Go figure. So, without any more squawking on my part, I present to you a 13th century Sufi writing by Muhammad. I gotta mention that the original manuscript that Muhammad wrote was written in Arabic. And it was translated into what I call religious English by a man named Biani. You have to understand that back in those, I mean, that's 13th century. When you were talking about God, it was all terminology was religious. Now, I took that religious terminology and I translated it into, without doing it any injustice, I was very, very careful about that. I translated it into a language that a source player, especially a source player that watched my videos, will understand. And the main topic is God. Now, let me insert here that God, whether you call it God or Allah or Krishna or Source or existence or consciousness, all those words mean the exact same thing. I don't have anything against God. Don't get that idea. I mentioned this in my first video. I had to change that name and adopt the name Source because the name, I was conditioned most of my life hearing the word God, and I had formed a mental vision of what God was. And I was way off base. And I knew it. So I changed the word. And for me, that made all the difference. All right. Without any more rambling, enjoy the video and pay attention. Pay attention. Take your time. I hope it clicks for you. I really do. Some people will ask, what does this have to do with the Matrix game of life? It has everything to do with it. Everything. Over and over and over, you'll hear it said, know thyself. That is the key that opens all the doors to escape pain and suffering and what we call the Matrix. All right, I'll talk to you at the end of the video. I'll have a few comments to make, so don't go away. At the end. All right. Later.
Praise be to Source. Before its oneness, there is no before, unless the before is it. And after its singleness, there is no after, unless the after is it. It is I am, and there is not with it any before or after, above or below, closeness or distance. There is no where, no when, no how. There is no time, nor is there space, or motion, or moment, or duration, nor any manifested existence or place. Source is now, how it always has been. It is not composed of name and form, for its name is it, and its form is it, and there is no named or formed other than it. It is the apparent without appearance, and the hidden without hiddenness. It is the very existence of the letters of all names, of the first and the last, and the hidden. Understand this, so as not to make the mistake of those who believe in incarnation. It is not anything, and no thing is in it, neither body entering into it or coming out of it. Its veil is its oneness, since nothing veils it other than it. Its own being veils itself. Its fist of being is concealed by its oneness without any condition. No one other than it sees it. No prophet, no saint, no angel brought close knows it. Its prophet is it. Its messenger is it. Its message is it. And its word is it. It sent itself through itself to itself. There is no intermediary other than it. Because of this, Source said, whosoever knows their self knows their source. What Source pointed out is that you are not you, but you are Source, and there is no you. You never were and never will be. Whether through yourself or through it or in it, or in it or with it, you have neither ceased to be nor are you existent. You are it, and it is you, without any of these imperfections. Most of those who claim to know Source make the knowledge of it dependent upon the passing away of existence and on the passing away of that passing away. The knowledge of Source does not require the passing away of existence or the passing away of that passing away, because things have no existence, and what does not have existence cannot pass away. Passing away requires the prior existence of the thing that passes away. If you know yourself without existing and passing away, then you know Source. If not, then not. What is the way to knowledge of the self and the knowledge of Source? This is the answer. It consists of being aware that Source is, and that nothing is with it, and that Source is now as Source has always been. Then Source showed the prophet what is other than itself, without the existence of what is other than it. So he saw things as they are. That is, he saw them as the essence of Source, without how or where. The word things applies to the separate self and to other things, because the existence of the separate self and body and the existence of things are equal in terms of being things. When you know the things, you know yourself. And when you know yourself, you know the Source and the ultimate reality of the universe. Because what you think is other than Source is not other than Source, but you do not know it. You see it, and you do not know that you see it. When the I is divested of the I, only the I remains. The end.
All right, I hope you enjoyed that. I really do. I hope you understood it. Like I said, it's deep enough that it has to be nearly studied to pull out of it the depth of the knowledge, the understanding, and the wisdom that Muhammad's words hold. It's incredible. It's amazing. Some of you might even find it scary. I know I certainly did. When I came to the understanding of what's being expressed by Muhammad, well, let me put it this way, because I've already mentioned it a few videos back. It had such an impact on me that I entered into a 3-month depression. How weird is that? I said, when I mentioned this, I think I mentioned it in a video when I talked about spiritual experiences. And I said, when I mentioned the depression, I said, I didn't know why I got depressed, and I didn't when I made the video. It's how things work in a game. Little by little. A bit here and a bit there and a bit here and a bit there, and it's revealed to you. And all those pieces start falling together. And I think that that's eternal. I don't think there'll ever be an end to that. Because the possibilities are unlimited. Meaning that knowledge is unlimited. But that's another story. I'll get into that in another video. I want to ask you to do something for me. If you feel like it, if you care to, if it's important, if it isn't, it isn't. It doesn't make any difference to me. But if you in the comments section of the video, I would like whoever cares to comment in 10 words or less. 10 words or less. What this video says to you. What you think or believe it to mean. Okay? It gives me an idea of where people like you who watch these videos, it gives me an idea of where you're at. It's not that I'm nosy, but I'm putting up videos to help. And I don't want to waste your time, and I certainly don't want to waste my time. Not that I'll stop putting up videos, but I'll know who to get into a good conversation with and who's not ready for a good conversation yet. Does that sound hard? Then it's hard. But that's it. Okay. 10 words or less, comment what this video means. Not the entire video, but the writing. The writing that you read and that I narrated. So, peace be with you, and may your Matrix game be one of health, wealth, and prosperity. Please come back. If you haven't already, please subscribe. And if you haven't already, please support me. Part of the game is making a living. That's part of the game. If I choose to do it this way, I love my job. That's one way to put it. All right, folks. Peace be with you. I'll see you in my next video. And remember, watch this video more than once, like 2, 3, 4 times if you have to, because I want the narrative, the writing of Muhammad. I want it to click for you. I really do. And you'll know when it does, because the hair on the back of your neck will stand up, to say the least. All right. Until we meet again, so long from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.